Excuse me, if you have a vacant seat next to you, could you raise your hand or scoot in or do whatever so that we can see if there's any extra seats? We're going to add a little bit of, we're going to add a row too behind the students there, but if you could raise your hand, let people know you've got empty seats by you. Again, if you have an empty seat next to you, could you raise your hand or move over and fill in? There's more seats up here at the top for those of you that are down on the main area there. There's some empty seats up at the very top up here.
Good evening, everybody. It's my absolute pleasure to see you all here tonight and to get ready to begin this performance for a full house. Very exciting, so thank you for being here. This evening, we'll be hearing performances from our 6th grade, 7th grade, 8th grade, and high school groups, and we'll try to get on and off stage pretty quickly and keep things rolling along for you. Just a quick reminder before we get started, if you could please make sure to have your cell phones silenced, and also if you can keep the talking and whispering limited or none at all during our performance. It's very distracting to myself and the musicians, and I want these kids to be able to give the very, very best performance for you. I don't know if I said this already, but I'm Miss DeSalvio, and I'm the director of orchestras here at Claussen, and the sixth grade is going to start off by performing Jingle Bells. For our next piece, we'll be joined by a couple of the 7th grade bass players who are going to help us out to perform We Will Rock You, recorded by Queen.
Thank you.
Thank you. The last piece that the sixth grade will perform for you is based on an old folk song called The Fox Went Out on a Chilly Night, and the name of the tune is The Fox Went A-Fiddlin'. Thank you. If we can get our lights on backstage, the sixth graders are going to carefully get off stage, and the seventh graders are going to carefully get on stage. Okay, we're going to quickly tune. If you could give us your patience, and then we'll get started. Thank you. Thanks. This is our seventh grade string orchestra, and they're going to start off by playing a piece called Asobu, which in Japanese means play.
Thank you.
Thank you. Our next piece is a more classical piece, originally composed by Handel. And in this piece, we worked a lot with dynamics, working on making our instruments get loud and soft and do everything in between. So hopefully you'll hear some of that in Overture for Strings. Thank you. Our next piece is a popular piece that's played around this time of year called the Ukrainian Bell Carol. And you've probably heard a lot of different versions. I know I have, including one done all by cats meowing. We're not going to do that one for you tonight, but I hope you'll enjoy this one.
Thank you.
We're going to invite our 8th graders up to join the 7th graders for our next piece. Okay, we're going to take another quick tuning note, and then we'll be right with you. Okay, so I wanted to combine the 7th and 8th grade to play one of their pieces, and I envisioned that we would rehearse it a few times and it would sound great, and in reality we rehearsed it once together and it did sound pretty good, and hopefully it'll sound even better tonight. This piece is called Epic, and the composer named it after the thing that young people like to say, like, epic fail. So that's what this piece is named after, and hopefully it will not be an epic fail this evening. The seventh graders are going to carefully exit the stage, and then the eighth graders are going to continue with their portion of the performance. All right, this is the eighth grade string orchestra, and we're going to start off by playing a traditional folk song in the Irish fiddle style called the Irish Baker.
Thank you.
Our next piece is a little bit more mellow, and it's also a classical piece called Larghetto. Thank you. Thanks for being a great audience. Our next piece is called The Dance of the Tumblers.
Thank you.
Oh, good, it's still working. Okay, the high schoolers are going to be dismissed to get their instruments because they'll be up next. And, oh, there they go. Oops. And the eighth grader's last piece is... Okay, sorry about that. The eighth grader's last piece is called Angels in Royal David City. Thank you to our eighth graders. They're going to carefully leave the stage now, and our high schoolers are going to join us. All right, we're going to pick a winner for the 50-50 raffle while these guys are getting situated. And this is my daughter, Taliana, and she's going to pick a ticket for us. Thank you. Nice choice. And the total was $132. And the number is 566-3372. Okay, anybody? I'll read it one more time. 566-3372. If you realize, I think I see somebody standing. It's him. And if you're interested in one of these flowers decorating the stage, you can see the boosters after the performance.
Tavia, you need pliers? Okay, I'll send Jim down.
Thank you.
Ready? Okay, so thank you for your patience. We have our high school group up on stage, and our first piece is actually a world premiere, a piece that was written just for us that's never been performed before. And this piece was written by a Clawson alumni, the son of our band director, actually, Kevin Phillips. And he's going to come up and say a couple words about the piece, and then he's actually going to direct the piece with these guys. So hope you enjoy it.
Good evening. I'm happy to be here. We actually just pulled this together with a few rehearsals, and I'm sure a lot of turmoil behind the scenes because the piece is actually quite difficult. I've had a blast just working with the students here, but actually about the piece, it's meant to imitate 18th century inner movements of a symphony by, you know, Mozart, Haydn, those kinds of things. And they're often really fun to play in sort of the style of a waltz, a very fast three. So that's all we're going to do, and we'll see you at the end.
Okay. I hope you enjoyed that, and it was very, very fun for me to work with a living composer and a great opportunity for the students, so we really thank Kevin for writing that for us. Our next piece, oh, yes. Our next piece is an arrangement of God Rest Ye Merry Gentlemen.
Thank you.
Our next piece is a little bit of a longer piece. It has four movements or sections. And when you hear a group play a longer piece like this with different movements, you actually hold your applause until the end of all four movements. And you'll know when to applaud when I put my hands all the way down and I turn around. So that'll kind of be your cue, and I'll kind of nod at you. So just wait for your cue. So what we worked on with this piece is kind of capturing the different mood of each movement. We've got the Western Swing, and then a really kind of somber movement called the Southern Lullaby, the Cowboy Waltz, and then Shaker Dances. So hopefully you'll kind of feel the different moods of each of these movements and enjoy all four. Nice job, orchestra, and nice job, audience. Before we play our last piece, I just want to thank all of you for being here tonight, and especially all of you parents for encouraging your children to continue playing their instrument and for sharing your children. I say it every year, and it's true every year. It really is my pleasure to work with them each and every day. And we were talking a little bit today about just how cool it is to be able to take your emotions and expression and really put them into your playing. And I hope that's kind of what you've seen happen starting from the sixth grade, where they're kind of just learning the notes and getting the hang of things, to the beautiful playing that the high school is doing. So thanks for being here. Hope you enjoyed every minute of it. And our last piece tonight is Boreas. Thank you all for being here tonight, and as always, thank the administrators for keeping music in our schools. If you see one of them, please thank them, and everybody have a great holiday.